Welcome to a lesson on conversions involving area and volume. The technique of dimensional analysis can be used to convert from one unit of area or volume to another unit of area or volume. However, it is important to remember that more than one dimension is being considered. And therefore, to convert from one unit of area to another unit of area, always use the conversion factor 2 times. The exponent of 2 on the unit is a reminder that there are 2 dimensions to consider. When converting from one unit of volume to another unit of volume, always use the conversion factor 3 times. The exponent of 3 on the unit is a reminder that there are 3 dimensions to consider. For part A, convert 10 square feet to square inches. We first write 10 square feet as a fraction with a denominator of 1. Now we multiply by a unit fraction that will convert square feet to square inches. The next step is to form the unit fraction so that feet squared will simplify out or simplify to 1. And because 10 feet squared is equal to 10 feet times feet, to form the unit fraction, we use 2 conversion factors from the conversion 1 foot equals 12 inches. So to build the unit fraction, we know we must have feet in the denominator, and therefore we have inches in the numerator. Using the conversion 1 foot equals 12 inches, part of the unit fraction will be 12 inches divided by 1 foot. But notice how this unit fraction is not enough to simplify out both factors of feet in the numerator. And therefore we need 2 of these conversion factors to form the unit fraction. So we multiply by another 12 inches divided by 1 foot. Notice now we have square feet in the denominator as well as in the numerator. And therefore the units of square feet simplify to 1, or simplify out here and here. Also notice how when multiplying, we're left with inches times inches, which does give us the correct units of inches squared. So multiplying 10 times 12 inches times 12 inches equals 1,440 square inches. Now we know 10 square feet equals 1,440 square inches. The next conversion is a volume conversion. We want to convert 7.2 cubic millimeters to cubic centimeters. We first write 7.2 millimeters cubed as a fraction with a denominator of 1. Now we multiply by a unit fraction to convert cubic millimeters to cubic centimeters. Because the units are cubed, the unit fraction must contain 3 conversion factors using the conversion 1 centimeter equals 10 millimeters. This should make sense because 7.2 millimeters cubed really means 7.2 millimeters times millimeters times millimeters. So if we want millimeters cubed to simplify out, we must have 3 factors of millimeters in the denominator. To build a unit fraction, we start with millimeters in the denominator. Because the conversion is 1 centimeter equals 10 millimeters, we have centimeters in the numerator, and therefore the conversion factor is going to be 1 centimeter divided by 10 millimeters. But we need 3 of these conversion factors in order for the millimeters cubed to simplify out. Using this unit fraction, notice how the units of millimeters cubed will simplify to 1 or simplify out. Also notice how we have centimeters times centimeters times centimeters, which does give us the correct units of centimeters cubed. So multiplying, we have 7.2 divided by 10 times 10 times 10, which equals 1,000. Well, 7.2 divided by 1,000 is equal to 0.0072, or if we want 0.0072, and the units are centimeters cubed. 7.2 millimeters cubed equals 0.0072 cubic centimeters. I hope you found this helpful.